Hello there, it's Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome to a brand new card making series here on my YouTube channel. I am doing a month-long series with Lawn Fawn as the theme for my projects. I'll be bringing you a video each week. This will be episode one. Let's look at the supplies I'm using today. Mostly the Tiny Winter Friends. I'm also using the Santa from Tiny Christmas. I'll be using this house from Winter Village. And I am making a Magic Iris card with the Magic Iris Snow Globe add-on. I'm also using this deer from Over the Mountain. Now, I did something that maybe you've done too. I ordered two of the same stamp set on the same order. So I'm gonna give one of them away to one of you. All you have to do to enter is leave a comment below and I will announce the winner on next week's episode. So stay tuned for that and good luck. Now it's time to color all these cute images that I have stamped out. I'm using Copic markers and you can see the marker number on the screen if that interests you. I actually love coloring these because they're so small that the coloring is just really simple to do. So I used two colors on some things, but like here for the shadow on the snow, I just used my C2 marker. So really, really easy Copic coloring, and you don't even have to do blending if it's not your thing. But I find them just fun to color because of the ease and how quickly they are done. And I also have to say, I love that the Tiny Winter Friends has so many things that coordinate with it. There are the birthday friends, there's the original tiny friends, and then there's like tiny Christmas, tiny Halloween, and then they will also fit in the little car. So lots of things you can coordinate with these. Now I'm going to die cut out all the things with the coordinating dies. You can see them all done there. I did add a white highlight with a white gel pen. Next, I am using this cover plate die, the snowflake cover plate die. I forgot to show at the beginning, and I die cut that from a piece of white cardstock. And next, I'm going to use my Distress crayons. I've never, ever used these before, but these new mica crayons, or the I think they're called pearlized crayons, came out and I was like, oh my gosh, I have to try them. So I got a few sets, and on this paper, I needed a little bit of water. So I just wet my finger on a baby wipe and then this blended out so much better. So I decided to kind of trace the middle of the snowflake instead of doing a circle, and that worked so much better. And I even went back over my original one and was able to blend that out with a little bit more crayon over the top. And I thought it looked super cool. I love that it has a little bit of sheen to it. Next, I'm going to take the same color Distress Mica spray stain and spray that so it has a light mist over the top, and then I'll remove the nozzle and do some splatter with that. It's going to dry back a little bit lighter than it looks immediately. So I don't know, this might look crazy, but most of this is going to be covered with our snow globe. So once that was dry, I decided to add some color to the edge, and I found that the Salty Ocean really works well with the snowfall color. So if you are looking at color coordination for the mica colors, there's one for you. Okay, now let's move on to the Magic Iris. I have three of these donut shapes, and I'm die cutting this gear shape from the center of one of them. You can see I also have three of the sausage shapes and then three of the straight pieces, but you'll see that be put together in just a moment. I wanted to go ahead and ink up the pieces that need ink as far as the snow globe goes and the Magic Iris pieces go. So I'm inking up the outside of the snow globe and the inside of the Magic Iris with my Salty Ocean. I'm going to splatter all the things first, water, let that set for just a minute, and then pick up the excess with a paper towel. Next, some more of that mica spray. This is, it's just like kind of having customized shimmer paper with splatter. I am loving it so much. Next, I'm adding snow. This is just white acrylic paint. I also did this to my background. It was a lot more subtle because it had more white in that background, but oh my gosh, I love this look. And some of it's gonna dry back lighter as well. Now, these are the circles that come from the middle of the Magic Iris donut shape. I saved two of them to create my background. So I just cut one at kind of a rounded edge. I didn't worry about die cutting it. And that is gonna be like the foreground. And then the other one is gonna be the background. And I just smudged around some of that mica crayon so I could have like a blue glow behind the house, and then I can glue everything in place to make this teeny tiny adorable little scene. And then I'm sticking this to a post-it note. I'm going to press the entire thing and cover the entire thing with some VersaMark embossing ink. This is a very sticky, wet ink, so it's great for embossing. And I'm going to use another brand new to me product, the Frosted Crystal embossing powder. This is not like your regular embossing powder because it's not shiny when it melts at all. It's frosted crystal. It looks like some water froze on top of it. And I just thought it would be a really cool look to have this on top for being inside of a snow globe. Do you see that kind of texture there? It makes it like have a little bit of a vintagey feel. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. Okay, so here's another die cut from the Snow Globe die set. I stamped Happy Winter from my Tiny Winter Friends set, and I'm going to emboss that with white powder. It'll pop so nice on top of this red paper. Now it's time to put the magic iris itself together. So I decided to glue two of these handle pieces back to back, let that dry because it makes it a lot more sturdy. Then I'm going to insert the sausage pieces into that donut shape that I die cut the gears from, and then there's little X's on the end of these, and there you're going to add your miniature glue dots, one to each of those X's that it's cut into the paper. So it's a guide for you to know where to stick these, and it's amazing. Now you want the sausage pieces to be like perfectly lined up with the donut piece. So I like to use some lightweight, low tack tape. This is Heffi tape, and that's just going to hold it there for me. I don't press it down. I really want it to hold loosely. Then you take a second donut piece and stick that down, lining up the two donuts together, and what's holding that down are those glue dots. And then you can just easily remove your low tack tape there. Now there's guides when you flip this over that are for where you're going to put the adhesive to attach these arms. I like to do some tape runner and some glue. Like, this is a interactive card that has moving parts. I like to make sure it's not gonna come apart. So I did that. Now I'm gonna flip that back over, add my handle to the right of one of those arms, creating a V shape. Then I'm going to put that third donut on top, add some more adhesive to the arm pieces that are sticking out, and then we're going to wrap this around. That's what's going to hold the top donut in place, but you don't want it to be tight. You want to wrap it around loosely so that there is a little bit of room for this to move. Now, once that's done, you can kind of play with this and test out your magic iris, although it is hard to do in midair. Sometimes the back of the little sausage pieces will show, so I fold them down. Okay, now we can attach the snow globe to the magic iris. I have the magic iris laying on my background, so that tab, the handle, is in the upper right corner, and then I can attach my snow globe to it. Then I have the pieces to decorate my snow globe, the base of it, that I die cut from some holographic paper. You just use the same snow globe piece, but cut off the snow globe top. And then they have these accent pieces in the die set that really bring the base to life. And then I'll add that sentiment right over the top of that. And I just love holographic paper for little die cuts like this. Now, there is a die in the Magic Iris set that creates an arrow, so I just added some more ink to that. I did spray it with the mica spray. That's the only distressing I did to it. And then I cut it again from red paper so I could have a little red arrow. My colors are kind of that turquoise and red theme for today's cards. Then I saved these little pieces and paper piece them back in place so there wasn't like a, you know, like a divot right there. Next, I have this ocean wave border. Sometimes I show you all the things I'm going to use, and then when I'm creating, I pull out more things. So I wanted there to be some snow for my snow globe to sit in, so I die cut two panels, but you can see I used it to make scallops instead of to make waves. Next, we can attach the snow globe. You only want to put adhesive on the back of those arms and then the base, but I recommend using all foam squares so it moves more easily. I had to do some card surgery and remove mine. Now here I'm adding those snowflakes, but take note, I've already added the snow to the front of my scene, and I opened up my magic iris and dropped that circle with my seam inside and adhered that into place. Next, I'm going to add my Santa, one of my reindeer, and my snowman. I'm actually saving the other reindeer for my second project. Next, I brought in the Holiday Helpers stamp set because I liked the Merry Christmas in this set and stamped that with lobster ink. I still had some more leftover snowflakes. These snowflakes are from the Magic Iris Snow Globe add-on set, also cut from the holographic paper, and I put that around the Merry Christmas. Next, I have some rhinestones from Trinity Stamps that I'm adding to this card. I'm adding red ones to the center of those snowflakes. That looks so fabulous. And then I have the winter white I'm adding around my snow globe for kind of more of a snowy look on that part. And I just love adding gems, and these rhinestones are some of my favorites. Next, I'm going to add this to my card base. Now, I paper cut my background so it was like an eighth of an inch smaller than my card base. So it had that white border all the way around, and there you could see it opening and closing. Next, I wanted to make these little boxes, the tiny box. See, all the things are tiny, go together. This is the tiny gift box. I die cut them from red, and I wanna create these to hang in the tree. So I sprayed this with some mica spray stain. I think it's candy cane. I don't remember the color. Peppermint stick? Something like that. I didn't quite let the mica dry long enough. So when I splattered it with the red and it soaked in, some of that turned a little bit pink, but it worked out fine. I used a different scallop from this set to create the snow for this. I thought I was going to have the snowboarders wrap all the way around the boxes, but I didn't in the end, so I didn't actually need that much. So I stamped some more images to fill in the scenes for these boxes, and that is the world's tiniest candy cane stamp in the land. It's so cute. I also took this free gift, the Holiday What's Up Critters. That's similar to the name, if not the exact name, and stamped out Merry Christmas on a little talk bubble. I love talk bubbles. And then I am adding a little ink to the edge of those snowy borders and die cutting some initials to go on my box. Those are my daughter's initials. Then back to the tiny gift box. I'm just getting all the things ready for my boxes. I die cut these circles and ended up stamping the word love on those so I can write love mom. And then I'm also going to die cut two bows from the gift box die set and put those together to go on top of my box. So this box has, you know, like so many sides to have lots of cute things on. Plus you could even put cute things on the inside of the box. So many options. I wanted to really make this cute because I want them to be for my girls to open up on Christmas. They have a little present on the tree. So in the lid of the box, I'm going to poke a couple holes that I can actually fit that twine into. This is, I believe, peppermint twine from Lawn Fawn, and I'm going to add that so it can hang from the tree. Next, I'm going to fold on all the scored lines, and then I put some double stick tape on the tabs, but you really only need double stick tape on two tabs, not the middle tab, because that's where the lid goes, unless you wanted the lid to stick closed, which I don't. So I just grabbed it and peeled it up, and luckily it peeled up really good, and I think that's because there's mica there. So I do strongly recommend the use of the glue and the double stick tape on this, especially if they're going to be in your warm house by the heat vent on the tree with all the lights, you know, it's just kind of a good idea. So I removed the other one too. And then I took both ends of my twine, pushed that through my hole. And then I just take the ends, wrap them around my finger. And then you take the ends and tuck them through the hole you've created and pull that tight. And then that creates a pretty thick knot. So that's not going to come up through the hole. Now we can decorate this box. Isn't it cute just like that? I'm going to add a little scene to the front, and I tried to color the girls both for the snow globe card and for these boxes to look like my girls. So this one would be Hannah, and I have her holding a candy cane and offering it to the reindeer. And then I will have their initials on the side of the box. It's going to say Merry Christmas. It's going to have Love Mom on the back. And then I'll have a little bow on the top. So these can hang in the tree and have a little surprise gift for them. It could have money. I think I'm going to put a crystal in it. My girls are really into crystals. And I've always had this dream of having a little miniature tree on a table in my foyer, and it would have all edible things decorating it. And like candy canes and maybe popcorn balls and gingerbread cookies wrapped in cellophane. And then when people came to visit, they could take a little treat from the tree. So these would be really cute on the tree, and they could have like a little chocolate truffle in them, or I don't know, something sweet. I think that is such a cute idea. These would also be great as Advent boxes, where you could put numbers on them and each day the kids could take one off the tree. I love that idea. So there are the finished boxes. I think they are darling. Why are tiny things so cute? I don't know, but I love the Tiny Friends stamp set, and I know you will too. If you leave a comment, you're going to be entered to win this stamp set. And if you already own it, it wouldn't be a horrible gift to one of your friends, would it? So you can always give it away if you have it. And I will be back next week with another Lawn Fawn Christmas video. I'm not going to focus on the same stamp set like I do for Stamp Set of the Month, but just my Lawn Fawn Christmas things, because I love making Christmas cards with my Lawn Fawn stuff. So stay tuned for that next week, and I'll announce the winner of the Tiny Winter Friends stamp set then. Thank you so much for stopping by. You can find the supplies listed below. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up to let me know, and I will be chatting with you in the comments below. Happy stamping. Bye.